Guys, this is Gabriel Z/LeMaine here at Bronx Comic Con with the head organizer,
Rey Felix.
Rey Felix, here at Bronx Comic Con, also known as Bronx Heroes Comic Con.
Bronx Heroes Comic Con, that's right.
Okay, so Rey, how did you get this little event here together?
Oh, we got this event together by a lot of sponsors like Bronx Council of the Arts and NISCA and New York Cultural, Department of Cultural Affairs, and lots of other people. Just talking to people, letting them know my vision and dream, and having them believe in that dream.
Okay, I see that Bronx Heroes isn't just really a brand. Is it really just a brand made for the con? Is the thing in and of itself?
It's beyond the con. We do T-shirts. We have comic books. We're networking with Bronx Pop, and we are doing like a soda label also, which we featured at New York Comic Con last year. The whole concept of Bronx Heroes is to let people know that they can do the same thing. It's not just about Comic Con. It's about creativity. It's about starting your own book, your own art line. You're into fashion or whatever you want to do, or accessories, or it's just about to motivate people to be creative and to use their creative mind to start a business and become entrepreneurs.
Okay, so Rey, like for me, like I know that Bronx is the birthplace of like a lot of creativity through the birth of hip hop and the like. So, do you know any Bronx history with regard to comics?
Yeah. Batman was created in the Bronx. The guy who created the original Green Lantern was from the Bronx. Stan Lee went to high school in the Bronx, and they all went to Clinton High School. So Bob Kane, Stan Lee, Irwin Hasen, and Will Eisner all went to the same high school in the Bronx, Clinton High School. Will Eisner created the Spirit.
Oh, pretty cool. So, I mean, like, I guess one thing that kind of comes to mind is that very often, like, when you see a city in danger, it's usually Manhattan.
Yeah.
And they usually go to rest of Queens. Like, why has Bronx been so neglected in the superhero landscape?
I think because a lot of the Jewish immigrants were kind of like ashamed of where they came from. Like Stan Lee used to say he was born in Manhattan, and Bob Kane said the same thing. But time and again, you find out that they actually lived in the Bronx. Like, Stan Lee lived on Kingsbridge Avenue. He didn't admit that until he was like in his 80s. So it's like, I mean, these guys are, you know, there was a certain shame associated with the Bronx, and I guess the stigma stuck with them, and it wasn't until their golden years that they started talking about, you know, having a sense of pride. Like Will Eisner's first graphic novel was A Contract with God. That was the first graphic novel in America ever published, was about the Bronx. So, and that came out in the 70s, when you guys were just little babies, not even. So, yeah.
So, like, what's your... So, like, I see you're an artist. Do you have, what's your training been like? What's been like?
Well, I was self-taught primarily. I loved to, like, write. I was more of a writer, and then I became an artist when I couldn't find someone to draw my stuff. I went to school of visual arts. So I went to a regular high school, went to Band of Childs in the Bronx on Gun Hill Road, and I ended up going to the School of Visual Arts, studied there. That's where I studied cartooning and fine art, and later became an art educator. And then I got a master's in language, so I have a master's degree in English, and I've taken classes at the Art Students League, you know, when I'm bored. But I'm pretty much self-taught artist, and I just publish my comics and draw my comics, and that's pretty much it.
All right, thanks, Rey. It's been fun.
All right, man.
This is Z/ from our hole in the wall signing off.